Mind your decisions, I'm Presh Talwalkar. In square ABCD, E is the midpoint of AD. Construct a circle between the three points E, B, and C. Which shape has the larger perimeter, the square or the circle? I saw this problem on Math StackExchange. It was described as a surprisingly hard problem for high school students. Pause if you'd like to give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching to learn how to solve this problem. I'm going to present three different ways to solve this problem. Let's get started with the intersecting chords theorem. To begin, we'll construct the perpendicular bisector of the top side of the square. Since point E, this top point, is tangent to the circle, this perpendicular bisector is a diameter of the circle. It also bisects the bottom side of the square. So if this length is equal to y, this length will also be equal to y, and the entire side of the square will be equal to 2y. If we write r for the radius of the circle, then 2r is the diameter of the circle, and the remaining distance on the diameter is equal to 2r minus 2y. Now we can use the intersecting chords theorem. We must have 2y multiplied by 2r minus 2y is equal to y multiplied by y. Let's simplify this equation. We'll first distribute, and then we'll group like terms. We'll then factor y, and we can then solve this equation. Y is either equal to 0, or y is equal to 4/5 r. Since we want y to be a positive value, so the square side has a positive length, we reject y is equal to 0. Therefore, y is equal to 4/5 r, which means r is equal to 5/4 y. Let's now calculate the square's perimeter. A side of the square is equal to 2y, which means the perimeter is equal to 4 multiplied by 2y, which is equal to 8y. Now let's calculate the circle's perimeter, or its circumference. That'll be equal to 2 pi r. Now r is equal to 5/4 multiplied by y, which means 2 pi r is equal to 5π/2 multiplied by y. And this is approximately equal to 7.85y, which is definitely less than 8y. Therefore, the square has the larger perimeter. Now let's proceed to the next method, which uses a property of right triangles. We'll proceed like method one, where we have the perpendicular bisector. Notice this will also be perpendicular on this side of the square. We'll label the lengths as before, and now if this is the center of the circle, this length will be equal to r, and this length will also be a radius of the circle. Now if this distance is equal to x, what must x be equal to? Well, we want the entire side of the square to be equal to 2y. Therefore, we must have x plus r is equal to 2y, which means x is equal to 2y minus r. We now consider this right triangle. By the Gogu theorem, we have 2y minus r the quantity squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. We can then simplify this equation, and just like before, we end up with a very similar equation. We have two possibilities, and we reject y is equal to 0. And this proceeds just like before, where we calculate the perimeter of the square and the circle, and we're going to get that the square's perimeter is going to be larger than the circle's perimeter. Now, on to method three, using similar triangles. Let's construct the following chords of the circle. We have this chord and this chord. Now, this entire triangle will have an angle that's inscribed in a semicircle. Therefore, this is a right angle. Now, that means this is an altitude on the hypotenuse of this right triangle. Therefore, it divides this right triangle into two similar triangles. This is the larger right triangle, and it has a ratio of its short leg to its long leg equal to 1/2. That's y over 2y. This will be similar to this right triangle, which must have the same ratio. In this triangle, the longer leg is equal to y, so the shorter leg must be equal to y over 2 to get a ratio of 1/2. We now have r as the radius, which means that 2r is equal to 2y plus y over 2. We then have r is equal to 5 over 4y, which means, just as before, we calculate the square's perimeter and the circle's perimeter, and we're going to get that the square's perimeter is larger. I know there are many other ways to solve this problem. It's a really fun one. Do check out the thread on Math Stack Exchange, and you can share your solutions over there. Thanks for making Mind Your Decisions one of the best channels on YouTube. As always, thanks for watching, and thanks for your support.